Up next on Pop Fusion the Talk Show, Omar Wilson talks being the Black Sinatra, working with legends, and debut album Living Legend.
Hey, superstar, how are you?
I mean, take a superstar to know a superstar. How you doing, baby?
Appreciate you. I'm doing well. How about you?
Man, just trying to make it through, you know, all this craziness going on in the world and smile at the same time. That's it, you know?
Yeah. Thank you so much for joining us today. You know, congrats on all of your success. You have some fans in here. Ladies are going crazy, saying how fine you are, how good you look.
I want to thank God and my parents for that, you know? you know, it's my job to help bring that R&B back. Like, I really feel like, you know, R&B is going to come back in a big way. You know, it's a blessing for me to be at the forefront of it. I bring to the table, you know, that real alpha male lion, a real manly approach to R&B music. And I'm looking forward to giving the ladies what they've been missing. You know what I mean? And I really feel like this record that I've been blessed to do with these three other amazing brothers is going to set a reset a trend for what R&B music is and the level it needs to be on and stay on.
Yeah, so tell us about that record. You're doing a rendition of an amazing song by Quincy Jones. You just put it out, I think, this morning, the flyer I saw. Can you tell us who it's with and how that collaboration came about? Super dope. I'm so excited. And then also, are you guys going to do a music video to that?
Okay.
So first
question is, one of my homeboys had brought the idea to me to do a record with him about it, and the situation didn't work out. So I believe the second or third day after I brought it to my label's attention and to the other cat that does the producer for us, my man Jazz, they already created the beat. So then it was like, okay, trying to find the right combination of individuals to make sure that it emulates what the record was and still we take it to a next level. So it was just an organic search for the other three brothers, which is Raheem Devon, Sean Stockman from Boyz II Men, and Cisco. The record, it came out phenomenal. I really believe Quincy Jones and his camp is going to be pleased with our rendition and just reinvigorating the spirit of what that record already is, which is legendary. And once again, it shows four alpha male brothers coming together as one and singing our hearts out for the ladies. So I really feel like this record is going to, you know, do justice not only for us as artists, but for R&B in itself.
Yeah, I love that. When I saw that flyer this morning, I was so excited. I'm like, oh my God, this is going to be so dope. So congrats on that.
Thank you. And as far as the video, we definitely all are looking forward to shooting a video of it. It's just with all the constraints of what's going on.
Yeah.
You know, please, you know, all the fans out there and radio and everybody, please bear with us. But we do want to shoot a video where we're all together as one. You know, I think that would be the right thing to do. But if push comes to shove, we'll do what we have to do to put out a visual that's pleasing to the people.
Yeah, definitely. And I mean, I'm so happy that you guys are still figuring out ways, like as musicians and artists, to be creative during these times. Your debut album, Living Legend, is available now on all platforms. Definitely. What was the inspiration behind that album? And did you write that album when we were in quarantine, or was it earlier?
The album was written prior. I had a couple records that just made the cut for the album. Then probably about half of them I wrote on site. The album is just an introduction to who Omar Wilson is, and really creating and starting that bond, that relationship with the people. You know, so it's kind of like a roller coaster ride through the emotions of who I am as a person and how what I feel is missing in music right now. And we've got a couple real great singles off of the album. And it's still to this day, the records are doing well every day. I think the more people become familiar with me, the more they'll understand my music and why it's so important right now, just in music and in time.
Yeah, definitely. You know, there's a lot of music out right now that, you know, I feel like we can dance to and we can vibe to it, but it really doesn't have a lot of meaning. And I feel like your songs are just so beautiful, like uplifting. The lyrics are great and it has meaning behind it. So thank you for being a contribution to good music in like this day and age. And specifically like 96, I was listening to that earlier. I know one of the writers was Keith Sweat, And yes, that's incredible. What does it feel like working with someone as legendary as himself? Have you taken away any gems from him?
Of course. It's just another confirmation of years of hard work. Of like they say, you know, when you will it into existence, you know, the universe will come around to you. And I've worked hard to do everything in my power to make sure my moves are on an A-list level so I can prepare myself for the opportunities that have been presenting itself to me in the past couple years. And it's just a confirmation. It's a comfortable transition. And it's an honor to learn from people that not only have a track record of greatness, but they have OJT, they have on-the-job training, they've been through the ups and the downs, so they can kind of give me the cliff notes of what to do to get there even quicker.
Love that, cliff notes.
Yeah, you know, you got to have that mentor.
Right,
you know,
remember mentor, those?
Industry cliff notes. Yeah.
Right? I'm not reading the book, I'm going straight to it. No, I'm kidding.
Yeah. I mean, I'll read the book too, but you know, right? sometimes when you're in the spin of things, you got to think on the fly.
Yeah, definitely. Love it. Well, Pop Fusion TV, we celebrate celebrities and influencers who are using their platform for social good. So I heard that you were part of the Global Citizens Together at Home concert series. Definitely. What was that like?
Man, it was emotional, man. It was emotional. Oh, wow. It was life-changing for a lot of people. To see so many artists in their own environment, it was more intimate, you know. For me, I mean, I sung Change Gonna Come, which was the signature song for the records that I sung for Global Citizen, and it almost brought me to tears just because I've been, you know, touched by a couple of my family members have had the COVID. One of my friends, his mother and father passed away. Like, you know, so it's definitely a direct impact on how real the situation is, no matter what people say about it. You know what I mean? People are passing away from it. So I think it was that kind of hit me as I was singing it. And knowing that my job is to be, you know, a conduit for people, is to be the voice for people that don't have one. They're somewhere crying in the corner. And it might be the way that I propel the song that lets them know that they're not alone. So it definitely was, you know, one, an honor to be a part of that event, but two, it was a blessing for me to give my energy to the people as well.
Definitely. And thank you for being so transparent and vulnerable and sharing that moment with us. You know, my condolences for your losses, but kudos to you for just being strong and handling it and using that, turning that into positive energy to help people, you know, continue to wear their mask and take this seriously. So thank you for doing that.
Oh, I believe it's my job. I mean, God gave me the voice. He gave me this opportunity. And that's part of being a star, I believe. You know what I mean? Of course, you want the money, the fame, the amenities, and all the things that come with it. But there's a great power, great responsibility. And that's always been in me anyway. You know what I mean? Like, when I first started doing music, it wasn't to be a star and so everybody loves me. It was to put things out there to help people that need it the most. And music is the ultimate conduit of healing the soul. You know what I mean? So it evolved into what I am now. But I'm thankful for that mind state. So, you know, it's always been a different perspective. It's always been about the people.
Yeah, definitely. And I mean, I think we can see that through your whole brand, through, you know, your image and through your music. You know, you're doing amazing things. And I wanted to say congratulations for being nominated for an Image Award. That is incredible. Man. It's really hard to even be noticed to that capacity. So congrats. When you got that news, like, what did you think?
Man, groundbreaking. It was a groundbreaking achievement for me. I mean, you know, there's people that have 90, 100,000 followers, this, that, and the third. So sometimes you think those demographics are the only thing that allows a situation like that. But once again, perseverance, hard work, dedication, having the right team in place, and being ready for the opportunity when it presents itself. Because sometimes great opportunities happen as such as that, but if you're not prepared even just to deal with the commentary, it might slide through the cracks. So it was definitely like, it was like getting that diploma, getting that magna cum laude diploma to prove that all of the things that I've done, that sometimes people haven't understand the unconventionalism of our field.
Yeah.
When they see certain results, they're like, it only can come from hard work. There's no other
Definitely.
Way.
Definitely. Yeah, especially when it's like that tangible like result, like you're seeing it in the flesh. It's just like, man, this is real. It's really happening.
This is real. Yeah. And at the same time, these people with these high accolades are just like you and me. So it also shows you what I call the Clark Kent Superman theory. Clark Kent was Superman, but he wore different outfits depending on what he was doing. So, you know, it's like, okay, just like you, just extraordinary opportunity and reach for the top.
Definitely. Love that. Love your whole personality. You know, congrats again on all that you're doing. What's next for you? I mean, I feel like, you know, you're bigger than just a musician. I feel like you are doing so many incredible things and you're using your platform and it's a movement. So what's next for this movement?
Well, the Secret Garden will be the first single off of a classic album that I'm releasing. At the end of August, I believe.
Okay.
So I wanted to just fully get out paying homage to the greats before I even embarked on, it will be, I guess, my sophomore album as me writing my own album, but it will be my third installment because it'll be my third album. So I'm putting an album out now called Omar Wilson Sings the Classics, and I'm covering records from Donny Hathaway to Teddy Pendergrass to David Ruffin, like voices that, I mean, as humble as I can say this, there's not too many people can sing. And for God to give me this texture and the ability, I feel like it's my job to give that to the people. Plus, people have been missing that type of music, you know,
yes.
All backgrounds, genres, ages, and demographics. So this album that I'm putting together encompasses some of the greatest soul voices ever to touch the earth. And I've done the research. There's people that have done renditions of different soul legends, but never all this many in one. James Brown, I'm doing Bobby Womack, you know, so, and it's all, you know, my label BSE and my partner Jazz Joyner, they're the production team. They're phenomenal at recreating renditions where they pay homage to the record, but they also make it so Black Sinatra, Omar Wilson has his own signature. So I really feel like this classic album is going to be the crowning achievement on me solidifying myself as an A-list artist in this R&B soul music world.
Oh my gosh. Well, so many more award nominations to come. I mean, this is going to be incredible. I'm definitely going to be staying tuned for that. And please, again, tell everybody, you know, where they can follow you on social media. Where is your album available? I know you said on all platforms. Did you mean?
Yeah. The Living Legend album. I mean, on our first, I think it's our fourth single now, which is 96. We had 96. I had the one. I had the Groove. There's been so many great records off that album, and that's available on all platforms, no matter where you get it, Apple, iTunes, Apple Music, what have you.
There's so many.
Yeah. I don't know, I remember them all. As far as social media, of course, you know, my Instagram is Omar Wilson 1. Facebook and Twitter is just Omar Wilson. I also have a website, which is owilson.com, or you can just Google my name and a lot of great stuff will pop up, videos, interviews, things of that nature, which I will put this one up as well. And there's pretty much no way you can miss me right now.
Right.
Yeah, the world understanding that, you know, I've been here for a minute and I really feel like it's my time to really show my ability. And once again, like you said, to give the ladies what they've been missing as far as singing to the depths of their soul. So
yes, we need some real R&B music.
Oh, it's back. I mean, that's even the tag of the production team, their tag is real music. And I really want to start that. I want to start that campaign. R&B music is back. I know for a minute they were saying whatever they were saying, but that's over.
Right. Yeah. Oh, well, good. Thank you again for, you know, stopping by and speaking with us. And congrats on your studio, by the way. You know, you're in it. It's open. That's a blessing as well. I hope Definitely. You stay safe. Continue always. Spreading your message. And Pop Fusion TV is always here to support you.
Oh, man, I thank you for your love and your blessings. I mean, especially all the way from Cali. That's one of my favorite places. I used to live over there in the valley off Ventura Boulevard.
It's hot in the valley.
Yeah, I know. It's like 1,000 degrees more hotter in the valley. That's where all the musicians were, so. You know, that's where I resided. But love L.A. Man, y'all be safe out there. Please stay home because I'm so looking forward to doing what is one of the best things that I do, and that's performing live. That way I get to give my energy and get it from the people. And that's the best feeling in the world for an artist.
Yeah, definitely. We'll be back soon, you know, maybe January, February, some point. But okay, until then, well, like you said, you know, just stay safe out there and continue doing amazing things. And thank you again.
No, thank you. Thank you for the opportunity. This is a blessing, an honor, and a pleasure. And make sure y'all just stay tuned. The record Secret Garden is coming out in a couple weeks. It's going to be a groundbreaking achievement for R&B. And once again, I'm blessed to be a part of it. And shout out to all the other brothers that are allowing me to be a part of this phenomenal situation. And thank you again for everything. I appreciate you, baby girl.
Thank you. Likewise. Stay safe out there.
You as well. Bless.
Bye.